Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. So today in this video we'll be talking about React.js interview questions. Those were shared by one of our subscriber friend who recently had gone through interviews with HCL, Accenture and ADP, and he has sent out the list of questions those were asked in these three companies. So here is the mail that we have received from our friend. Most asked React interview questions: HCL, Accenture and ADP. Hi team, I found your channel recently and had to admit that you are doing a great job. I have 4.3 years of experience as a front-end developer. Below are the few most asked React interview questions that I have faced recently in interviews with companies like HCL, Accenture and ADP. So in the next slide we'll be talking about the interview questions. If you want to share your interview experiences with us, you can reach us at the email ID that is there in the description. If you can post your, like, you can send out an email about your interview experience and we would be sharing that through our interview videos. That would be helpful for larger section of audience. So here are the interview questions. List some of the major advantages of React. List some of the limitations of React. Is lifecycle methods available in functional component? When does React application render a view? Update the state in React. What is the difference between functional and class component? So these were the first five questions that were shared. So guys, before getting further into the video, would like to talk about the leading hiring platform of the country that is Relevel by Unacademy, and we would be talking about the current backend openings that are there on this platform. Like, let us see what are the top five companies that are currently hiring a backend development guy. So the top 5 companies are Razorpay, SuperDaily, FlickText, Moengage and Animal. And let us see what they are offering and what is the required skill set for them. So coming to the first company, that is Razorpay. So the CTC is 20 to 24 lakhs per annum. The required skills are PHP, Python, Java and CPP. And the second company is SuperDaily, and the CTC that is being offered is 20 lakhs per annum. Required skills are Python, AWS and big data. And coming to the third company for backend development, that is FlickText, and it is offering a salary of 15 to 25 lakhs per annum, and the required skills are Java, J2W, Spring Boot, design patterns, Kafka, Spark, AWS, machine learning is a plus. So, and the fifth company, that is Animal. So it is offering a whooping of 15 to 20 lakhs per annum, and the required skills are Node.js, Python, MySQL, MongoDB, Google Cloud, Firestore, etc. So if you want to get into these companies, you just need to register with Relevel by Unacademy and take the test, and based on your score, you will be shortlisted for the interviews. And once you get shortlisted for the interviews, you will be given a special guidance by Relevel team in cracking the interview. And the entire process of this is only, like, the duration of this process is just 1 week. So within 1 week you will be getting the result, whereas compared to other technical like other platforms, other, it is like the time is never ending. You there is no guarantee that when the process would end, but here it is just 1 week. So what are you waiting for? To grab this golden opportunity, visit Relevel by Unacademy site and register for the exam, take the exam and crack your dream job. And if you want to use the coupon code that is there in the description, you will be getting an extra 10% discount on the registration fee. And if at all you are able to crack the interview, the entire registration fee will be given back. So what are you waiting for? Go and register for this test right now and start your dream career. So now let us talk about the second set of questions. Can we create React application without JSX? Why is functional component better than class component? What are the lifecycle methods in React? What are the difference between controlled and uncontrolled components? How to prevent re-renders in React? How to pass data between React components? What is virtual DOM? How does React use the virtual DOM to render the UI? So these were the next section of questions. And the final section is this: what is React Router? Why do we need a router in React? What are higher order components? Why is switch keyword used in React router v4? What are synthetic events in React? What are the different phases of React components lifecycle? What is Redux? What is Redux thunk used for? So these were the questions, guy. Here is the complete mail that was sent on August 2. I found like already gone through this. You can halt for a moment and you can go through these things as well. I hope this might be helpful for at least React developers, because we are most of us are from Angular, so we don't know answers for this, to be honest, because we never got a chance or opportunity to work on React projects. Most of us have experience on like on Angular only, so Angular, or we are backend Java developers, so we don't know the answers for this. So that's the reason we couldn't say the answer. So just sharing the email so that it might help someone who is looking out for similar interviews questions on React. So if you are on our channel for the first time and wondering who are we and what we do, so we are basically a bunch of software engineers who attend interview and share our real-time interview experiences through these videos. You can visit our channel to get to know like what all interviews we have already shared. And if you want to contribute us, you can reach us at the email ID that is there in the description. And if you haven't subscribed us, you can subscribe us. And if you're wondering what are the company names, these are the companies that we have already shared the interview experiences. You can visit our channel and get benefit out of it. If you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe, because there are a lot of videos that are coming up. If you like the video, like it, share it to other technical platforms so that it might help someone who is looking out for similar kind of videos. You can provide the feedback in the comment section. And thank you for watching, and all the best for your interview preparation, and all the best for your interviews.